back to Guitar by Emily. Today is a very fun and special video. Today I'm going to be showing you all the footage and the videos from the Kiss concert that I went to about a month ago, and I'm going to be talking about Kiss and of course the concert and just giving you guys a little bit of a review, and then of course all the vlog material that I got from the actual concert. So this is going to be a really fun one. Make sure you're subscribed and you give the video a like, and you go over to my Instagram. There's a lot of pictures and videos from this concert over there as well. And I have a lot more concerts and events planned for the next year and the coming months. So make sure, again, that you're subscribed so you don't miss any of the things that I posted about all that. It's going to be really fun. Lots more stuff coming. Before I get started talking about the actual concert, I did just want to kind of bring up a little bit of why I wanted to go see Kiss and what Kiss means to me as a guitar player. So the reason I actually started playing guitar was Kiss, and I now typically say that my biggest inspiration is Steve Vai, and that's true, but when I started actually playing guitar, I didn't know who Steve Vai was. I really didn't know a lot about guitar players and music, but it was actually New Year's Eve, and I think 2021, I think that's the year, and they played a live show on TV in Dubai, if any of you guys remember that, or if you watched it. It was during kind of quarantine, and concerts weren't really happening, but they had this live concert to kind of kick off the End of the Road tour, and me and my dad really had nothing to do that evening, and my mom was at work, I think, so we were just kind of watching TV, and we decided to watch it, and that was the first time I had really seen electric guitars being played. I'd, of course, heard music with them in it. I've always loved 80s music, but I've never really, like, listened to it a ton. I didn't really care that much. But for some reason, when I started watching that concert and I was seeing the guitars being played and I could hear it, and just something about it was amazing, and I just loved it so much. And immediately after that, I was like, I need an electric guitar and this is what I want to do. So that's really what kicked off the electric guitar journey for me. So that's why Kiss is kind of a little bit special to me as a guitarist. While they aren't really my biggest inspiration as a player, they were the reason I started, so they're always going to be special to me, and I love their songs. A lot of their songs are great, and 80s Kiss is probably my favorite. Bruce Kulick is my favorite Kiss guitarist, but Tommy Thayer is a close second, so it was really awesome to get to finally see him at this concert. So let's just move into that now. So we planned on coming to this concert. It was in November. It was Thanksgiving weekend, so that was really fun, just kind of big holiday weekend break from school and going to see Kiss in Indianapolis. So that was really awesome to get to do that around the holidays, just a fun event. And let me tell you, I was so excited. This is just almost like a big full circle for me, because like I said, they're the reason I started playing. So to catch them on their End of the Road tour, the last time they're going to be playing, was absolutely incredible, and I was so excited to get to do that. So I filmed a lot during this concert. I filmed the entire trip, and there's a ton of footage from the actual concert. So I hope you guys enjoy. I hope you like watching all of this. If you want to see more videos like this from future concerts that I'm going to, make sure you leave me a comment down below letting me know that you want to see more vlog type videos like this. Again, if you're not super interested in like the traveling and things like that, you can go ahead and skip to the concert footage. There's a lot of good concert footage. So I really hope you guys are excited. Let's watch the vlog.
just got some Starbucks and I just wanted to give a little bit of an update because the concert was a little bit up in the air for a second. Paul Stanley had the flu, but we just got confirmation that it is on tonight. So I'm so excited. Gonna rest up in the hotel a little bit, maybe watch some football, and then we're gonna get ready to go. I am so excited.
My sparkly eyeshadow is epic.
You think it would hurt if I had some?
You can have some.
Did you bring the black and white for me?
Blank what?
Black and white tomato.
No.
You said you're going to practice the starch oil and you're ready to put it on me when I'm talking.
No, that's me. I'm going for the whole Paul Stanley vibe. You have to be someone else.
Definitely not the cat.
You can be Jean.
Jean's is the coolest, but Jean is Jean, so I'll do you an ace, I guess.
You just don't get to be Paul, I'm sorry.
hope you guys liked watching that. It was really fun. I had a lot of fun putting all that together and editing it. So I guess to wrap up and talk about the actual concert, because I didn't film anything afterwards because I was pretty much speechless. It was so amazing. Paul Stanley, I just can't believe that he was able to perform like that with having the flu. And like I said in the video, it was up in the air that the concert was even going to happen. We had to go ahead and travel there so that we were at the venue planning on it did happen. But it could have gotten canceled because he canceled a couple other shows, but I was so happy that it didn't. It was like nothing I'm ever going to see again. Nothing's going to be like Kiss. I mean, the effects and the pyrotechnics were insane. It was a full-on show. It was not just a concert. It was a complete show. The music was great. The guitar playing, incredible. Like, Tommy Thayer is amazing. And no one gives Paul Stanley enough recognition as a guitar player as well, because he's such a flashy showman, frontman. He's an amazing singer, but no one really talks about him as a guitarist. And he kind of got to show that off in the guitar duel between Tommy Thayer and him. So that was really cool to get to see that in person. I really like Paul Stanley. I think he has an amazing voice. I just love his personality. I think him and David Lee Roth are probably the best frontmen from the 80s. I think they definitely did the best job, and I've just always really liked Paul. So that was just so fun to get to see everyone like in person. It was almost surreal. It didn't feel right or real. It was just so incredible. And the show went on for about 2.5 hours, which was crazy. They played so many songs, and the venue was really great as well. There were so many people just singing along, and especially when they played Beth and the flashlights, everyone got their flashlights out on their phone. That was so cool to look around and see all of that. And of course at the end, you guys saw all that confetti and the streamers and all the fire going off. It was insane. I wasn't expecting that, so that was so fun. And what a way to end the show. Just got to do it big. Everything Kiss does is big. So that was just amazing. They just put on such a good show. I just really don't even know how to explain it. If you've not been to a Kiss concert, I don't think you understand how amazing and epic and over the top extreme everything is. It was just so good. Everything was perfect. Absolutely loved it. I would recommend that you guys go see Kiss, but that was the end of the road. They finished it out in Madison Square Garden. I was able to watch that on TV. They did a pay-per-view of that, and it was really great to get to see them play their last show. So it was good to be a part of that, and I'm very glad that I was able to be a part of the last tour of Kiss. I know I'm kind of in the wrong generation here. All these bands are from the 80s and 70s and 80s, but it's really great as a young person to get to be a part of that before it's all over. So definitely great show, amazing. If you guys can maybe catch a show recorded or a past show, definitely watch it, even though you're not in person. Just, they put on such a good show, and it even carries across the TV screen. So definitely recommend checking that out. Hope you guys really enjoyed this video. Again, make sure you like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.